Please stand by for our broadcast from the National Emergency Warning System.
Channel. Today we have a looking at the crafting event for the Merkava Mk 3d. This is actually a pretty cool addition to the game. There's been a couple of announcements so far for this upcoming event, and I haven't touched on those yet. Didn't see what they were. We've got a ship, an armored car, and a half track, and an aircraft so far. This is the one that's most appealed to me. So what we're looking at here is the Merkava Mk 3d, also known as God's Chariot. The Merkava is a tank design that started in the 1970s, and is still in service today in the fourth variant. This is the third variant. This comes with additional armor, gun, ammunition types, overall just superior protection, superior engine power, and firepower. This thing is a big upgrade over the previous variants. So if you've played the previous variants before and wish you just had a bit more, this is going to be the tank for you. Now, let's have a look at what War Thunder has to say about it. Merkava 3D is a later modification of the well-known Israeli main battle tank developed during the 1980s. Featuring improvements in all aspects, but most notably in firepower, thanks to its new 120mm smoothbore cannon, the Merkava Mk 3 will soon become available in War Thunder tankers in the upcoming crafting event. Now, with the crafting event, there's no information on that yet that I've seen, so I'll leave that bit of information as it is. It's going to be a rank 7 main battle tank. It's got a new 120mm smoothbore cannon. This is a native gun designed in-house in Israel and built in Israel. It's supposed to have comparable firepower to the Abrams tank. However, it doesn't fire armor-piercing depleted uranium armor-piercing rounds, but no tank in the game currently does, so that's not a big deal. It has increased armor protection and improved mobility. The mobility comes from an increased engine power. I believe it's 1,400 horsepower. It is a heavier tank, but it can deliver quite a big boost to its speed, especially on paved roads. The armor protection, the design of this tank in real life was to increase the survivability of tanks. Israel started losing tanks to close quarter combat, especially. Now losing crew, and the most important part of a tank is its crew. You can rebuild a tank, you can build a new one, but you can't rebuild crew. So Israel, they decided to build a tank originally based on the idea of the Chieftain tank, but then they decided to make their own, which emphasized crew survivability above all else. Considering that a lot of combat in the foreseeable future would be in close quarters combat, so they'd be facing a lot of things like RPGs, etc., they went to work to design the Merkava tank. The Merkava tank uses sloped armor. As you can see, it's got that long, steep hull on the front to help improve its armor protection. It has a unique flat wide sort of turret, and it tries to make a small target of itself as possible, which is saying something considering it's a huge tank. It also has modular armor, which means it can quickly replace damaged armor on it. It can also quickly upgrade into new newer types of armor as they get upgraded over time. Now, even with a 1,400 horsepower engine, it's still slower than most other MBTs. But there's a balance, so we'll just have to see how this goes. I suspect that this is still going to be quite nippy for an MBT, which is going to be quite nice. And that slower mobility comes from the increased mass. The history, immediately after production of the Merkava Mk II, in 1983, Israel engineers began working on the Mk 3 version of the MBT. It introduced significant improvements over preceding variants in almost all aspects, primarily firepower. Primarily, however, the focus of the upgrades was centered around improving protection by adding additional armor to the hull, as well as mounting the newly developed MG251 120mm smoothbore cannon, purpose-built for the new modification of the Merkava, in order to increase firepower. You can see here largely the design you've already seen in the previous tanks. You can see the foundations are the same. It's still going to have a large anchor compartment here. As I said before, this tank put crew protection above all else. So they moved the engine to the front of the tank, so that if it took a shot or a hit from an RPG or a tank round, the engine would hopefully absorb the brunt of the attack, leaving the crew protected at the rear of the vehicle. This is where the engine sits. There is a bit of a gap in the front here where the driver sits. It'll be interesting to see whether that is protected or improved in this particular model. The other thing about the Merkava is, in real life, you can actually remove some of the ammo storage from the rear of the tank. And there's a large door in the back here, which allows up to 4 troops. So this can actually be used as an improvised troop carrier as well. This again comes from the idea that this vehicle might be used in close quarter combat, like in towns and stuff, where tanks become extremely vulnerable because they can't utilize their main gun, and they can be shot from all directions. They can't see the enemy coming. They can ambush from point blank range, through buildings, from rooftops, and from multiple locations at the same time. So they wanted all round protection and survivability for the crew. Ultimately, it's a very nice looking tank. I quite like the Merkava. What I really like is the actual combat variants that you see that have the chains hanging off the side of the turret, and I believe they also have them hanging off the sides and rear of the tank as well, which I believe are meant as protection for RPGs and stuff, meant to add additional protection in some way. I don't know how that works, and even if I've got that right, but it does give a different level of aggression to the tank. It looks far, far more aggressive. It's a beastly looking tank. This bit here joined the ranks as a high-tier gift vehicle. This means it won't be a premium. If anyone was wondering, this won't be a premium tank. So you'll have to research all the modules, which has been the same with the previous Merkavas anyway. Starting with the most notable improvements to the vehicle firepower, unlike previous versions of the vehicle, the Merkava Mk 3 introduced the Israeli 120mm smoothbore cannon, which shares many of its ballistic properties to the widespread RH120 and its modifications. This substantial improvement to the Merkava's firepower will allow aspiring commanders of which to engage in longer range combat, as well as to make it more comfortable in to battle others more heavily armored MBTs at the top ranks. Besides, Merkava has one of the most powerful kinetic rounds in the game. So this is going to be very interesting. One of the most powerful kinetic rounds in the game. Does this mean penetration? Has this got one of the best penetrating rounds in the game? And if so, what do they consider one of the best penetrating rounds in the game? Is it top 2, top 3, top 5. And if not penetration, does it just mean has this got additional post-penetration effect? A lot of these things don't really mean much until we actually get to test it. Furthermore, the Merkava Mk.3d offers improved armor protection, mostly notably on the turret. Part of the vehicle now houses a composite add-on package, which increases the Merkava's resilience against chemical rounds in particular, but also slightly increases the protection against kinetic rounds. So this bit here about slightly increases protection against kinetic rounds, that's going to be interesting. I suspect that largely means things like this whole section here is still going to be a massive weak point in this tank. Namely, the Merkava 3D is equipped with the Continental AVDS17909AR turbocharged diesel engine, generating a noticeable increase in power output of up to 1,200 horsepower. As a result, the additional horsepower not only makes up for increased weight over previous variants, but it also increases the vehicle's top speed to up to 60 kilometers an hour on paved roads. All in all, the Merkava Mk.3d is not just a worthy addition to any tanker's in-game collection, but also represents a major leap in performance over previous iterations of the vehicle. Therefore, if you were a fan of the Merkavas before, the Mk.3 is a must-have in your arsenal. On the other hand, if you previously believed the Merkava also lacked some more oomph, then you may wish to consider obtaining the Merkava 3D, as it will change your mind. That is God's Chariot, the Merkava Mk.3. What do you guys think of it? Is this something that you've been waiting for? I know I have. I was looking forward to the earlier Merkavas. I'll be fair, I found them to be a bit of a disappointment, but it's actually not going to stop me from grinding out this one. I am looking forward to this vehicle. Maybe you have something you want to say about it down in the comments below. Have you been waiting for this tank yourself, or are you thinking you might take part in the event, maybe for a different vehicle? Make some comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and subscribe.